Hi, thank you for listening. This is just a quick video. Last time I said that it was 40 minutes, but anyway, this is just a quick video about Scottish independence. I thought I was done with this. We all thought we were done with this 2 years ago when we made the decision no to independence. 55% of the entire country of Scotland voted no to independence. 45% voted yes, right? So this came up, it's been coming up and building up and building up, and this was in the newspaper yesterday. So I took photos of it, and when I got home and checked on the screen, I noticed that it's a wee bit blurry, but you can still make it out, so sorry about that. But anyway, the headline is Sturgeon, that's Nicola Sturgeon, she's the First Minister of Scotland, right, the leader of my country. My position on IndyRef 2, Democratic Independence Referendum 2, Democratic, right? Nicola Sturgeon has insisted her position on a second independence vote is rooted in democracy. The SNP leader was attacked by her unionist opponents during the BBC leaders' debate on Sunday for her comments on another referendum. Ms Sturgeon, who plans to launch a fresh drive for independence in the summer, was accused of keeping this wound open by Scottish Conservative leader Ruth Davidson, while Lib Dem leader Willie Rennie said she was being anti-democratic on the issue. Speaking on the campaign trail in Edinburgh yesterday, Ms Sturgeon said, "My position on a second referendum is rooted in democracy. If there is no demand for it, there won't be one. On the other hand, if people want independence, if it becomes the preferred option of a majority, then I don't think anyone has the right to stand in its way." It goes on for two more paragraphs or something, just talking about the debate, nothing special, but I wanted to focus on this part here. The people from the Yes camp, right, are there's two camps, the No camp, which I'm in, and the Yes camp, right. I know lots of people from both camps, and the majority of people I know from the Yes camp, when they heard that when the results were in, they were just like, okay, well, at least we tried, let's just get on with it, right. But there's a small section. The loud minority, there's a small section of the Yes voters who just cannot let it go, right? They cannot let it go, right? Even the leader of the country doesn't understand that no means no. I will tag her in this video, and I wonder if the leader of my country likes free speech so much that she blocks me. But anyway, they cannot let it go, and on Twitter for the last few months it's been building up, right, and people have a go at me, and they'll say things, the funny thing is they call me a yoon, Y-O-O-N, which is basically means someone in favour of the union, right, and they actually think that's an insult. You're in favour of the union. Yes, I am. You drink water. Yes, I do. How is that insulting again? I don't understand. But anyway, the plan is that she's going to go for another, you know, vote for independence 2 years after the vote was made, right? And they're like children, these people, right? They really are like children. I don't want to go down the name-calling road, but I'm calling them children because they're acting like children. You see the way you see children playing a game, and you have to do X in order to get a point. And then the ones that aren't getting any points then go, oh, let's make it that you get a point for doing Y, Z, V, W, you know, they start to make, they just make rules up as they go along in order so that everybody can win, basically, right? This is what they're like, they're like children, and this is what the plan is, right? This is what they're planning on doing. Tiring out the no voters, just a quick word on that, you'll never tire me out. Every time there's a vote, I'm voting no. So, I mean, you can try, but you won't tire me out. But the plan is to tire the no voters out so that eventually the yes voters get their way, right? So it'll go, right, let's have another referendum. Okay, the answer's no. Okay, let's have another referendum. Right, the answer's no. Let's have another, and so on and so on and so on until the answer is yes. And then when the answer is yes, like children, if somebody from the no camp then goes, will we have another vote on that? Like children, the people in the yes will go, no, 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 the decision's been made. The decision is final. The people have spoken. The nation has spoken. They are like fucking children. We had a vote on it. It was mass coverage by the media, even out with Britain, even people out with Britain were asking me, what's your opinion on this? Tell me about this. What? How are you going to vote? What's it about? You know, there was a lot of interest on this. There is no fucking way it's possible that anybody in Scotland could have missed this, right? We all knew it was happening. We all went out and we all voted and we decided as a nation, 55 to 45, no, we don't want independence, right? Now, a grown-up accepts that and just goes, right, okay. And if it was yes, I would have accepted it and went, okay, the nation has spoken. Isn't what I want, but I have to go with what the people want. But this part here, she says, this is what does my head in. She says, if people want independence, if it becomes the preferred option of a majority, then I don't think anyone has the right to stand in its way. But Nicola, the preferred option of the majority was no. So why are you trying to stand in the way of the people who chose no? They're the majority. They have already decided that that was their preferred option. So why are you now trying to stand in their way by having another referendum? You're like fucking children. You just want to get your way. And they also think that we'll keep doing this and we'll tire out those no voters, you know, and then the yes voters will win. But what they don't realise is they're also going to tire out the yes voters at the same rate. So it doesn't make a difference, because these yes voters are going to be like, oh yes, we'll vote again, yes, yes. And it's going to come to a point where they're going to go, oh, we're voting again? Oh, does that mean I need to pretend I care about austerity and food banks again in order to disguise the fact that I hate the English? Again? Do I need to do this again? Oh, didn't we do this 3 times in the last decade? Oh, again? I've got to do it again? Oh, Christ. You're going to tire them out as well. It's fucking ridiculous. Grow the fuck up, people. It didn't go the way you wanted. An adult accepts that. It was a fair vote. There was no manipulation. There was no unfairness involved. It was a fair democratic process. We decided no. No means no. Learn to accept that. Jesus Christ, Nicola, aren't you a feminist? Shouldn't you know that no means no? Christ, man. I've had it up to fucking here with this shite, man. Oh, we need independence. Well, we voted, we said no. It's no. The answer's no. Why didn't they take no for an answer? Didn't your parents ever teach you that? Fuck's sake, man, these are the type of cunts go, Mum, can I get a biscuit? No. Can I get a biscuit? No. Can I get a biscuit? No. I'll fucking have 10, you fucking little cunt. These are the types of people that were like that when they were children. That's the parents they had. They gave in. Fucking no. The answer is no. Thank you for listening. Until next time.